Hello and welcome back to my garage. In today's video we're going to replace an injector on my brother's Renault Megane. And yes, the Megane is already gone because we already did it. I needed to reshoot this intro. The reason was that my brother is a little bit of an impatient guy. And when I was shooting the intro, he already almost had removed the whole injector. So what was the point of the video then? Well, nothing if I went the same route if I normally do. So I did some bits and pieces, and to be honest, to replace the injector itself isn't the challenging part. It is insanely easy. I know that these things can be stuck in there really good. Not from experience, but I have seen people struggle with it. So keep that in mind. The reasons why I was able to remove this as easy as we did was they were already removed by a garage. A little bit of context. I know I can rattle on for a long time, but I will try to keep it a bit dense. My brother had some weird issues. First of all, it was another sensor broken, so we fixed that. No video about it, unfortunately, because my brother is a patient guy. I love him to death, but he is impatient. Literally, when we fixed it, the next day, it was running on 3 cylinders, and he came back, and I plugged in the scan tool, and it was saying that the 4th injector wasn't firing correctly, or firing at all. But that was not the only problem. It has a bunch of problems. ABS, radio, the AC, there were so much problems in that. It really dawned me, maybe there was a fault in the wiring or something like that. So I said to my brother, we can of course change the injector. The only problem is I cannot program this thing. So yeah, you have to go to a dealer. And because there were so many faults, I said to him, maybe it's better you go to the dealer and let it check it out before I'm going to, well, replace all kinds of things. And maybe it isn't the culprit, because I really thought it was the injector itself, and because of the injector, all the other things, came out of sync. But that was my speculation. He went to the dealership and they checked it out. They had to ship these injectors to a third company to let it check. Yeah, I found it a bit weird because, well, you're a dealer, a Renault dealer. Why do you need a third company to diagnose a problem? But that is how it is. And the annoying part, of course, is, you know, the third company wants to, well, make some money off it, but the dealer wants to have also a piece of that money what the third company gets. So you know that you're going to pay a little bit more. It's annoying, but that is how business works. So I had already in my mind, well, this is not going to be a pleasant bill, what he's going to get. He said, well, what do you think is broken on the car? So I said, well, the injector, I almost know for sure. Yes, I said, not only that one, but the other 4 are also not very, well, happy. They weren't broken, but they weren't that good. I already found out on the internet that these things cost, refurbished, about 150 euros. And new ones, I believe they're new ones, I don't know for sure, but they're around 250, 300. So you can get these for 150 to 300 euros. And he said to me, do you know what the price is to replacing all 4 injectors? Well, they wanted to charge him 1850 euros, if I remember correctly. So I said to him, well, that is insane amount of money. At least I find it an insane amount of money, because for maybe €1,000 you can get a low mileage, complete low mileage engine. So I was already in my head, well, we're going to replace the whole engine, or maybe these with secondhand ones. But well, my mind get off track a little bit easy. He said to me, not a chance that we're going to pay that. So I said to him, well, what do you want me, what are you going to do? Do you going to scrap the car, or try to sell it like this? Or so he said to me, can we fix it? He said, of course we can fix it, it's no problem. The only problem is, I cannot program the injector. The injectors had to be programmed into the computer. Try to figure out how that stuff works. You're good with a computer, so your problem, and figure it out. Of course, he did not say that literally to me, but that was the stretch of the conversation, or the point. That was the point of the conversation. So he talked to the garage. He said, "Put them all back, and we're going to do it ourselves." He had to pay €450 to remove those things and let them be tested. Also, they destroyed one of those leak hoses from the injector, well, back to the system. Also, they decided to use a normal hose instead of a fuel-graded one. And because of that, my brother had a massive diesel fuel leak underneath the car the next day. So, thank you, Renault, and that's the reason why I repair my own cars. Well, I will show you in a minute. It is maybe for one injector. Of course, if you can get them loose, that is then that's even the variable that I don't know. You can get them out within 10 minutes. So I found that the price was really ridiculous. Of course, I know stuff needs to be paid, but to be honest, it's maybe for them an hour work to, not even an hour work to get those things out and in there again. So that is maybe with the rate, maybe 75 euros. Yeah, dealer rates are really expensive. So let's say 100 euros for that. And well, maybe for testing, maybe another 100 euros would be fair. But yeah, he had to pay €450 for that. So he wasn't very happy. Removing the injector isn't really the problem. They can be really stuck, but as you can see on the top, you have a big hex key, and that hex, well, if you can get a wrench around it, you can wiggle it loose, and some penetrating oil always will help. You can get this thing out of there within 10 minutes, if it isn't stuck, of course. For the rest, I will show you here.
Well, first of all, we need to remove the battery terminal. And this is a 13, I believe. After that, you need to remove the charge pipe, and that one is held in place with a 10mm nut. And on the other side, you have that clip you have to pull out, and then you can, well, take it all off. The cover itself is held in place with two clips. And on the top side, you have in each corner a 10mm bolt. Also, you need to unplug the plug.
Well, because it is the fourth injector, we always count from the front, so 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is number 4. And we need to remove, well, at least the hard line. That's this one. So always disconnect both ends. Don't kink it or bend this line. You would definitely have some issues. And then there is just a bolt down there. That's the only bolt that's holding in this injector in its place. And that is just a pull lever. Well, let's figure it out. And then, of course, the plug itself.
The hardline nuts are 70 millimeters. Just be careful with them, like I already said. And if you remove those, then you can remove that bolt. And I believe it was a 13. That bolt has a, well, let's call it a kind of fork connected to it. Be sure that you don't drop that one, like we did. And after that you can remove that injector. And as you can see, for us it was quite easy. And this is the shot of the old injector. Be careful, there is a washer on the tip.
Een uurtje mogen rekenen.
You don't want to stack those washers on top of each other. And as you can see, we used a screwdriver to, well, first put in the washer. And when you have that thing in there, then just install the new injector. And then of course, put back the hard line, and as you can see, we already installed the plug at the top of the injector. Be sure that you snug up the nuts nice and tight. Don't over tight it, but you don't want to have it leaking. And then you have that other hose, and as you can see, you can just clip it in there. And then you put back that plastic cover. Be sure that you clip it on there with, well, those clips of course. And there are a couple of bolts that you need to install back in there, and those are 10 millimeter. And then you have to install that charge pipe again, and you can push it in there, and then of course that clip on top, push it down and be sure that it's secure. After that there's just one nut left, and that's also a 10, and of course be sure that you put back the power terminal of the battery. When it was time to reprogram the injectors, we found out that the fourth injector is the first one, and the first one the fourth one. Yeah, they counted the other way around, so that's something I didn't know. It's just weird, it's of course French, and it's annoying. Fortunately enough, it isn't a big job, so we swapped them around.
This is a can clip from Renault. Of course, this is not the official one. This is the a clone of it. This thing is about 150 euros. You can go cheaper. There are even cheaper ones on the market. Those are around, well, 80 euros, I believe. The only problem is that those can be unreliable. And also there are a lot out of there that can't program. So you can only do diagnostics. And I think you're better off paying a little bit more for, I believe you have a, that's called a green board, and one is a gold board, and the green board uses, well, Chinese brands or cheaper brands components on there, and those are not that reliable. So I think that little bit more, just to be safe, yeah, I thought it was worth it, and my brother thought so also. So that's why I bought this one. I will of course put a link in the description of the one I bought. If I can find them on Amazon, I will put them also. And that is officially a affiliate link, but I did not make any money off Amazon yet. And that is not, and that's okay with me, but that, you know, it is an affiliate link. So keep that in mind when you are going to look into one of these clips. If you bought one of these things and you get a really bad, in my opinion, a really bad instruction with it, I can just make a whole video about just how to install that software. I do not think I am going to do that, but I will give you some pointers with problems I ran into. Pointer number one is you have to use a 32-bit Windows. So a 32-bit Windows 10 works, Windows 7 works, Windows 8 works. Of course, don't use Windows 89 or 95 or 3.1. It's not going to work, and also DOS does not work. But if you have a Windows 7, 8 or 10, 32-bit, it will work, no problem. The problem is not that you can't install the software, because you can, I did it. The problem is the Windows won't recognize the device. So 32-bit is one thing. The other thing is, if you have installed it all and you think, hey, I'm going to plug in the device and the only thing he sees is a USB hub. And you think, oh, I need a driver for that or something, and it doesn't work, and you only see a USB hub. And it really drives me nuts, because I could not find the reason why it doesn't work. So I did some searching and reading and stuff, and there is not really a lot of information about it. But what I found out is that you have to plug it into the car and use your laptop. So be sure, it doesn't have to be a Renault, it just has to be an OBD plug. Plug it in and then use the USB, and then Windows will find this device. So that is tip number two. But I did found out some other stuff that no one talks about. One is, be sure that you have the ignition on. And with these kind of cars, the ignition is on for maybe 2, maybe 3 minutes, and then it shuts off again. So it's really annoying. So you have to constantly put a car on ignition again. That is problem one. Problem two is, I just get all kinds of errors. Stuff doesn't find, and there was problems in a couple of the matrixes or something like that. And I did some searching in the documents, and I found just a little note, and it says that you had to have the radio on. So that is step number two. Be sure that the radio is on. If the radio is not on, he won't find the injector system. I don't know what it has to do with each other, but this is just how it works. So be sure that the car is on ignition and that the radio is running. And this is step number three.
And tip number four is, be sure that the battery is fully charged, or maybe even hook up a charger to it. In some cases, when people bought the cheaper versions, they got problems. And one of these problems is the voltage. The apparatus doesn't show the right voltage. And if that happens, well, you cannot program your ECU. Now it's finally time to reprogram the injectors. Be sure that the ignition is on, and of course the radio. In the main menu, you have that little car icon next to the vehicle fin. Click on that. Press validate. After that, in the fenster OK. And it will go to the next screen. And we have, of course, wait a little bit. Press OK again. Then you see in the left corner, you go to Ken Vian. Choose injection and choose continue, and then OK again. And then we wait. And if you don't like waiting, well, don't go into IT. You will be waiting your life away, I can guarantee you that. After that, you get a pop-up, choose no, and press fault finding by computer. And again, press on Ken V1, and then in the top box on injection. After that, you click on the wrench at the top right, and then on the connection symbol on the left side. It's the fourth icon from the bottom. And there we have the enter injection codes. And here we have all our current numbers and of course required. And required is, well, the new code you want to put in there. And in our case it's Alpha 2 Foxtrot 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 Juliet. Or how we call it in Dutch.
A 2 F F F J.
F F.
And after that, of course, always check and then press validate. Now the system is programming. So just be patient and wait how you screw it up. This can be for your first time really nerve-wracking. I know it was for me. Well, it looks like it's finished now, so we press finish. And of course, we're going to double check if, well, the programming has succeeded. It did say it succeeded, but we want to know for sure. And it looks like it's going correctly, so let's try to start up the car.
Maar staat hij niet eens als hij op de snelweg staat. Moet hij toch pompen?
And that's basically how you do it. The only problem is that it took me a lot of time to, well, figure all the problems out. So hopefully with this video you don't struggle the way I did. There, like I said before, there isn't a lot of information about it, and the information that there is really lacking in my opinion. But then again, it helped me to, well, make this video, and hopefully I can help you. So, all in all, we did just replace one injector. The reasoning, my reasoning behind it, even because the garage said, because all four aren't that well, I said to my brother, we're just going to replace one. And if another one goes bad, then we're going to replace him then. Because, to be honest, the car is running really fine now. If it can drive another year, or a month, or maybe 2 years, without any problems, hey, it's fine by me. And of course we can reprogram it now ourselves. So next time, we're just going to buy an injector, plop it in there, and it isn't that much work. So why, it isn't that you have to spend 2 days to remove this thing. So, yeah, even if he is stranded on the side of the road, we can do it now. So, yeah, it is just, yeah, in my opinion, common sense. It is maybe, it feels better to spend now 300 euros instead of 750. If we can spread it over, well, maybe years, then it feels better. Of course, it's still the same money. I don't know about you, but I don't have money to spare. And 750 euros is a lot of money. But it's a lot cheaper than 1850 euros. I have learned my lesson. Next time, if something like this happens, I will just offer to buy one of these computers. Of course, the problem is this only works on Dacia and Renault. So if I ever have, maybe it also works with Nissan, but don't know for sure. Well, my mind get off track a little bit easy. Sorry. I'm of course not going to buy for every brand one of these machines, even though they're a lot cheaper than the original ones. It is just not worth it for me. But when I encounter it, I will probably buy one of these machines. But yeah, that's it for today's video. I hope you enjoyed it or at least learned something from it. And if you did, please give it a like. If you want to follow me around, so you know what to do. And I will see you next time. Bye.